So you probably have heard about berberine for PCOS and for insulin resistance, and I'm here to talk to you about this today. So stay tuned and I'm gonna tell you what I think about berberine and is it worth it to take it for PCOS. So welcome to my urban background today. I'm actually on my terrace and decided to maybe go out for a change and record this in a little bit more, well, not totally natural environment, but stay till the end of the video and I'm gonna show you what view I actually have from here, because it's quite cool. But if you are here, you probably struggle with PCOS or insulin resistance and you have heard of supplement called berberine. Now, I'm gonna be looking a little bit into my notes here, because I did read few articles, scientific articles and few other articles, and I tried to make a little bit of my own conclusions from them. So, you know, I'm not a doctor, I'm just a girl reading articles on the internet. I'm just gonna preface it before I start. Now, berberine is actually a natural supplement. It is a supplement that is made from a lot of different plant extracts, and it's supposed to work on your blood sugar levels and on your insulin levels as well. So you have probably heard it somewhere, you know, metformin or something like that. And metformin is one of the most common medication actually prescribed to women with PCOS to regulate blood sugar, insulin resistance, weight gain, and all sorts of stuff like that. I'm gonna do a little brief comparison of those two a little bit later, but let's go through what berberine is, and at the end I'm gonna compare which I think is better for you, berberine or metformin, for your insulin resistance and PCOS. So, berberine, as I said, is a natural supplement, and it has been used in Chinese medicine for centuries for regulating blood sugar levels. It also helps with other conditions that I'm gonna mention to you in a second. However, you know, it can be argued that it helps with those different stuff because, you know, this cascades from regulating your blood sugar. So berberine basically goes into your cells and changes how your cell reacts or how it, your cell works. So it's similar to many, many drugs, medical prescribed drugs that you can get. I'm not going to go to biological mechanisms because they're very, very complicated and sometimes they're not even very well known. However, berberine, it seems to be very, very active ingredient. So it already has been shown in the studies to have quite a strong effect. And let's just go through the few major things that it does. First thing, it regulates your blood sugar. So it will regulate your blood sugar, and as an effect, it will regulate your insulin levels. So if it helps you with your insulin levels, it will of course improve your insulin sensitivity. It will improve the digestion of carbohydrates in your body, digestion or, you know, energy changes of sugar in your body. It will also slow down the breakdown of carbohydrates in your gut. And what is an extra benefit is that it helps you grow the good bacteria in your stomach. Whether it is also by just regulating sugar and through that, you know, the good bacteria are being able to grow better, or is it something completely different? I don't know, it's not specified. However, it definitely helps with the diabetic patients. Now, it can help you lose weight, and I have found few studies that actually have shown that berberine was better in aiding weight loss than metformin was. So there are a few studies when they checked, you know, overall weight loss, but the one that I found was when they were measuring hip to waist ratio, and actually patients that were comparing patients who took metformin, berberine and inositol, and the ones who took berberine had the best results. Now of course you have to take under consideration that in every studies you can take a group of people and you can just somehow find the people who react better to certain stuff than others, and of course everybody is different. So the same person might react great for berberine and bad for metformin. You know, you could find a different person who would be the other way around. However, it seems like from the studies that berberine actually was the best out of the three to aid weight loss, which is a great news. Now, another thing is that it lowers cholesterol and may reduce your risk of heart disease. So that is also kind of a thing that is further down the road from insulin resistance. So what do I mean by that? Very often, actually, our high cholesterol levels are connected to high sugar levels in our body, because this is a common misconception that have been perpetrated perpetrate. For the last decades, that it's actually cholesterol that we eat that influences our overall cholesterol levels. However, now is being argued that it's actually high carbohydrate, high sugar levels, and high levels of carbohydrates that we eat, especially processed ones, that actually influence our cholesterol levels overall. Now, what you have to understand also about cholesterol is that majority of the cholesterol that we have in our body is not from food sources. It's actually created by our own body. And there is nothing wrong with cholesterol. Cholesterol is our body's patch to heal certain stuff. So for example, if we have a little bit of, a little cut inside of our artery, the cholesterol will go there to patch it, to heal it in a way. Yeah, it can mean that we have a lot of cholesterol in our arteries, but the cholesterol is not to be blamed. What is to be blamed is whatever caused this cut at the beginning, which I've heard might be actually sugar in our blood. Also, if you have been reading maybe about fat liver disease, it is also caused by a lot of carbohydrates in diet and not necessarily fats. So by reducing our blood sugar levels and by regulating our insulin, it will also influence our cholesterol levels in turn, right? Which is, of course, fantastic news, and it can be used not only for women, for men, for everybody. Now, another thing as well is that it can improve depression, so it can help you, have better mental state. It improves cancer. It has very strong antioxidant and anti-inflammatory effects, which is great news for women with PCOS, especially us who struggle with a lot of inflammation. It can help with infections, with bacterial, viral, fungal, and so on, which is very, very good still in this year. Fatty liver disease, of course, as I said, it can reduce that because it also is caused by high blood sugar levels. And heart failure, of course. And it has also been proven to lower the androgen levels in women, but then again, all of that is caused by high blood sugar levels. So if you're thinking about the fact that maybe you have symptoms of high androgens, like acne, like hair loss, hirsutism, maybe you have different symptoms, maybe you have a lot of inflammation in your body, all of that can be caused by high blood sugar levels and by bad blood sugar regulation. So all the medication that are gonna address that are gonna actually help with all the other stuff, right? So everything that's gonna address blood sugar is gonna address your cholesterol levels and other things in turn. And also, like, even within cancer, it's said that cancer is actually fed by glucose. So by starving cancer from glucose, it's said that you might reduce its spreading. But that's, don't quote me on that, because that is just something that I've heard in one of the videos, so I'm not sure. Now, the recommended dosage of berberine is 500 milligrams 3 times a day, but let's go into metformin versus berberine. Now, metformin is a synthetic version of the drug that does very similar things. However, as I said, actually if it goes to weight loss, it says to have a little bit lower effect than berberine does. Another thing is that metformin comes with very unpleasant gastrointestinal, whatever you call it, stomach issues, basically, like diarrhea, gas, stomach cramps, and so on. Sadly, berberine can have the same side effects. However, some people say that they're milder and that it's easier to actually kind of ease into it and that they're not as extreme as in case of metformin. Now, if it goes to regulating blood sugar, berberine, it's said to be the same or maybe even more useful as metformin is, but as I said, it is a natural thing. So it will be better for your body and it will have fewer other side effects as well. So overall, berberine seems to be something that is gonna come as a major player, I think, in the upcoming decade. Now, why isn't it recommended widely by doctors? Don't forget that, as in case of any medication, it has to go through a scrutiny, a very long testing process to actually be on the market. Now, from people that have been working in pharmaceuticals, I know that sometimes it takes 10 years for the medication from the first tests to actually come up on the market. So it cannot be according to regulations, it cannot be actually promoted to patients before it goes through all of those stages. However, the tests that have been made now suggest that it actually is very, very powerful, and it's a great alternative to a little bit more synthetic thing that is metformin. and that it could be worth trying. And also, because it's more natural and, you know, it's available to everybody, you can try using it a little bit and see how you feel and, you know, slowly maybe increase it. However, if you are already on medication like metformin or in any other medication that is lower your insulin levels, make sure that you contact your doctor before you start taking berberine, because it can further lower your sugar levels down, which can be very dangerous. So as you know, for example, in case of diabetics, if they use too much insulin and the blood sugar goes too low, they can even go to coma. So that it's not a joke. If you're taking any other medication that is lowering your blood sugar levels or your insulin levels, make sure you contact your doctor before trying berberine, and make sure that you're under constant checkups. But if you're someone like me, for example, that has, I was on keto for a long, long time, but now I'm thinking about reintroducing some carbs to my diet, like, you know, lentils, hummus, oh my God, chickpeas, carrots, maybe potatoes sometimes. So I'm thinking about taking berberine, because I know that my body very easily goes back into too high levels of everything, and it's just not handling everything as it should. And I'm thinking about, you know, giving myself more sources of vitamins and at the same time supporting myself with berberine. I don't know if it will work, but I like the fact that it's also helping with inflammation, which I have a lot of, and I have problems with my gut. So hopefully this will help me as well. Now let me know in the comments, please. Did you actually use berberine? How did you find it? Did you use metformin before? Did you try both, and which one was better? I would love to know, because I'm doing those videos for you guys. So the more I know from you, the more different stories I hear, the more it helps me. And also make sure that you like, subscribe, and click the notification bell to be notified about my future videos. Now I'm praying that this video is in focus, because I'm recording it second time and the first one was completely out of focus. See you very soon. Bye. By the way, this is my studio today. This is what is outside of that. Look, it's 2nd of January. Look at those flowers.